Good afternoon, my dear brothers and sisters here on the Great Turtle Island, belonging to the Americus Empire, under the Iroquois Confederacy, the law of Guisan, Iswanta, and the white rule supine, what we call the two rule wampum belt treaties, and also the Canes of Authority Treaty, BC Indians, West Coast Indians, and also to the Peace Pipe Treaty here in Cree Country, and in particular, Treaty Number 6 that was signed on October the 23rd, 1876, bringing the Peace Pipe, making the Creator as a witness. So everything that they do is, what they do against us is a witness against them. All of you who are on the panel are a witness against them to what they're doing to us as sovereign people. And greetings from the Creator to the four directions, north, east, south, and west, wherever you may be. And also to the gatekeepers for the north, east, south, and west, and wherever you may be on Mother Earth. With the Creator blessing you with gatekeeping, and also greetings from the Cree Nation, specifically here from the corporate country of Canada, in the corporate province of Saskatchewan, in the prisoner of war camp of Otakaku Preserve 104, the Dominion and Parliament of Canada, which is our enemy, and in particular, Prime Minister Harper. The election has been called on, so we're going to have an election here in Canada. The parties are Conservative, the New Democratic Party, the Liberal Party, and other parties. So, greetings from my immediate family here on Oskaugamak, here in our territory, what we call Treaty Number 6. The clan mothers have the alluvial title to Canada, and because every one of us is born of a woman. So the teachings of the clan mother come from Ksemantuskwil, which is Roa Kakadesh, the set-apart spirit, the spiritual mother, Mama Shekinah Glory, and Mama Gawinowski. So with that, ladies and gentlemen, dear panel, I'd like to thank you, Patty. I'd like to thank the panel members, Barbara Free Crow, Tracy Kennedy, Sydney Chief, Holy Walker, Lance Singer, Maiganawas, Stephen, Robin Davidson, Eric, if he's there, welcome to this program. Now, there's been a lot of questions regarding where we stand. There's been a lot of people that were complaining about the radio program. It seems to me that we seem to be talking things all over again and again and again. But I want to remind you, when I invite every panel member, whenever I pass the talking stick to you, you are free to discuss anything that's on your mind and in your heart. And if it has to do with the problems that we are encountering at this point in time, it becomes your duty and responsibility to make sure that whatever is on your mind, dear panel, will be forwarded in our discussion. The rapport that we are going to be discussing, which is impromptu, we have no agenda. We just allow our spirits to go and the spirit of intent, of treaty, and everything that we do, according to our own minds, what we call volition. After all, it's between you and the Creator, your panel members, and you have to be transparent and accountable. So Now, whether or not that we're going to be discussing these things on a human level, or are we going to be talking on a spiritual level, and each one of you on the panel and all listeners, you're a spiritual being, and your duty and responsibility is to carry out the Creator's law to the best of your ability. Now, whether or not each one of you on the panel are willing to sacrifice 10% of your life to follow the Creator, that's how much you'll get back. If it's 25%, you'll get 25% back. If it's 75%, you'll get 75%, but it's 100%. By allowing yourself and the whole spirit and everything that we're going to be talking about is spiritually discerned. We have to come to terms with this, dear panel members, my brothers and sisters, dear listeners, wherever you may be on Mother Earth, so that we'll be discussing these things. So with that, I would like to pass the talking stick, if I may, first of all, to a woman. And since she's on it and she's been taking classes, Tracy, could you please come on the line and please bring us up to date what's happening in your part of the world?
Thank you very much, Gerald, and thank you, Cal, the panel today. What Gerald and I have been talking about a couple times now off air is the new technologies. And I haven't presented to him because I told him I wanted to be sure and I wanted us to be ready. I'm very close, Gerald. And if people that are listening now, especially if you're Canadian, keep some pennies that are pre-1997. Just pennies, a couple nails, and find out what fruit you have in your area that is acidic or something with a very big leaf. And you're going to need tin foil. Within the next 2 weeks, I will have something presented to you that will not only put power into your house, but if these tests that I'm going to be running for the next 2 weeks work, you'll be able to wear it on your neck. So, exciting stuff. Like you said, Gerald, we're having an election rushed because people aren't dying fast enough for Harper. And we have Jade Helm, which everyone is being jaded by, which is an AI program that Gerald and I have spoke to you about for a very long time now. And there's a reason, you know, they keep bringing up these names. The lion was Cecil. They had this big rumor and whether or not his brother Jericho was dead. Was Jericho dead or not dead? And even Gerald, and we hadn't talked about this, talked about sacrifice. Cecil means blind, you know, as well as his brother, who was the second murdered lion. This is the time of the slaughtering of the lion kings, the lamas, first fruits ceremony that happened in Rome. We're seeing a replay of things. We're even seeing Iran under attack with meteors and a heat wave that was ridiculous. It was so hot there. It got up to 150-something Fahrenheit. It's just crazy. You can't go outside when it's that hot. So we are seeing major changes. I'm absolutely sure what's going on is real. But you got to remember, Kesh is from Iran. Iran is where you get the word Aryan from. They are the Aryans. These are the people who talked about the jinn. His technology is done in an enclosed space, like a bottle, like to summon the jinn. I'm concerned, but from what I've done so far, the majority of this technology, if it's done with the right intent, is good. And we were talking about those kind of things in the last show. You know, Chief Tudog was presented with a situation, one that was going to make him angry. some of the Confederate flag and they sass mouthing him because he's Native and looks Native and all that stuff. Know that good and evil is very close. Would Two Dog have been evil if he responded the way they want? No, he would have just been reacting. So we are on the head of a needle right now. Jade Helm is absolutely a computer program, and it is absolutely the fires that are going on that Gerald has spoken about are going on exactly the route where they want the new pipeline. This is not an accident. Police are being triggered here. That too is not an accident. All of these events that we're seeing, I know going into the esoteric stuff seems like I'm belittling it, but they are using names as triggers. These names have been put in front of us so that we'd remember them and have a response to them. So I would just like to say this program, this AI is learning from us right now. We need to be careful what we're teaching it. And thank you very much, Gerald.
Yes, on the note that you're talking about, and thank you for that overview, Tracy, it's important that you've got to realize exactly what you're talking about, new technology. And as far as the people, the experts have said, the technology that they have is over 300 years ahead of us. So the technology is very, very evil indeed, I guess, for the people who are controlling it. But in what Tracy is talking about is the free energy. On that note, when we're talking about free energy, for us over here in the panel member, Sydney, Lance, Stephen, Robin, is the free energy that we're talking about is what kind of energy are we going to be utilizing in order to be able to be on in balance. This is what we're confronted with. And to be able to write our truth on a piece of paper, which is our affidavit, is first and foremost. You have to write it down. Like what Evelyn Larson says, write your story. As a witness against them in regards to what we're talking about, in regards to the free energy, we have it. It's just a matter of utilizing it, what Tracy's talking about. He's working on those things so that each one of us, in regards to what they're doing to us by paying the utilities, the power, the gas, the natural gas, the prices, everything controlled by them. So how do we do it? Coming together as a group to be able to present to them a document that is written in truth. One of their maxims is in truth is in commerce, truth is sovereign. That is, use that as a byline. Write your truth down so that you can give them notice in your documents. And your document, your affidavit, has to be rebutted point by point. And how is it possible that they can rebut it when we're specifically talking about Kiche Manetu Uyeshewewin in our ceremonies? This is straightforward in regards to that. I would like to list the 10 foundational maxims of commerce from which all codes, law, and statutes are derived and based upon are, number one, a workman is worthy of his hire. Now, if Stephen were to do his ceremonies That means whatever he's working on, he should get paid for it. And all the rest of us. But who's controlling the money? The people that Tracy and I have been talking about, Barbara have been talking about, Patty has been talking about, and all the rest of the panel members. Number two, all are equal under the law, both moral and natural law. Moreover, between right and wrong. Natural law is everything in creation. Number three, in commerce, truth is sovereign, like I said before. Number four, truth is expressed by means of an affidavit. Number five, an unrebutted affidavit stands as the truth in commerce. Number six, an unrebutted affidavit becomes the judgment in commerce. Number seven, a matter must be expressed to be resolved. Number eight, he who leaves the field of battle first lose by default. Number nine, sacrifice is a measure of credibility. If one has neither been damaged nor incurred a risk and is unwilling to swear an affidavit that is true, correct, and complete, the commercial equivalent of the truth, the whole truth and nothing but the truth, on his unlimited commercial liability for the veracity of his statements and the legitimacy of his actions. He has no credibility and therefore no basis for asserting claims, charges, or claiming authority. Number 10, a lien or claim can be satisfied only through rebutted by counter affidavit point for point, resolution by jury or payment. These, dear panel members, are the things that we're talking about in the documents that you're going to be able to present to them to prove your sovereignty and your status as a child of God. All those things must come together according to the law of one. Now, these things that I've just stated, is that it becomes our duty and responsibility to come together, because the things that they're talking about, that they're planning, are they're going to go ahead and do it. The Creator is going to allow them to do it because of the simple reason that we are going to be put to the test to see exactly if we are the men we say we are, or the women that you were created to be in the energy of love. So with everything that's being said, with everything that we're being talking about, is it important that all of you who are in a panel members, specifically from the Cree tribe, we all know, according to Meredith Quinn, the clan mothers. One clan mother has already spoken, Tracy Kennedy. And I'm going to ask the next clan mother, Barbara, to speak. So go ahead, Barbara, please.
Thank you, Gerald, and the panel members. It's always wonderful to be here. There's so many things on my mind, try to get things straight, to know the best way to look at where we are now and what is essential, what's needed so much. And yesterday we were in ceremony in the Nippi, praying for the sun dancers, who are, this is the last day out there in Rosebud where I go to dance. Didn't get there this year. And we're praying for the people who are praying for us and the sacrifice that they're making and the faith that they have is so strong. And we were talking on the brain gym earlier about the faith, how important our faith is, the power of that faith. And where we are now in this time of transition, because we are really rapidly moving into a shift here. We feel it. We all feel it. We know this is time of prophecy, and it seems that every certain amount of years, 2,150 years, it is noted that a new world comes into being. And the new world is part of a prophecy that I think we're verging into. It indicates basically that we enter into a new constellation. And looking at the star system and the cosmic system and how we are connected to that. But the Earth is going through the changes, also dramatic changes through this transition as it is meant to be. Although it is a death of the old ways, we look at it as that, and a time of renewal. You can't have renewal without end, without the end of something, a death and renewal. This is manifested through, I feel, through Creator's law. We talk about that. Creator is in charge. We're not in charge. We have a part to play. We have a job to do. And I think it's essential that we have a strong focus on the fact that Creator is in charge. And but the job that we have, I believe, is to be part of this transition and manifest through the goodness and compassion in the way that we walk. You walk in a sacred manner. You are walking with, I feel, in the way Creator would want us to be, with compassion and love. And of course, that's a frequency and an energy. And our ancestors understood these transitions, the timeline of these transitions. So they're always knew a time would come, a time of change, of a death, and of letting go of the past. And this is where we are. Letting go of the past is the fourth world that we are leaving and moving into the fifth world, or some say 1,000 years of peace, the fifth hoop. What we're letting go of, or what we must let go of, is the chaos, the hatred, the violence, the judgments, the separation. Because this is, we know, deliberate pressure upon us to be separate from each other, to judge each other. We know that the elite, the cabal, that those entities that are caught with that Luciferian energy are manipulating us deliberately, step by step, every day. And it's up to us. The job that we have to do is to take charge and become the spiritual warriors that we are, that we were meant to be. I feel Creator, our ancestors, are looking to us to make this great shift into this new world. Now, many interpret this shift as the end times or the last days or the apocalypse, but you know, many also see this as entering into the new age, a new world or fifth hoop, as I said, and we're entering into also the age of Aquarius, the water bearer. And I've noted this in the past, that it is not a male, as seen in the zodiac. The image is a male, but it is a female. This new age of Aquarius that we're entering into is said to represent the next 200 years of the kingdom of healing. And some say beyond that, it speaks of our entering into that 1,000 years of peace. And I found this quote, Yeshua said, "Go into the house of the man who holds the water pitcher." And I say man never carried the water or went to the well. Women always carried the water. And women were the ones who went to the well, and they still do today. In many foreign cultures, women still carry the water from the wells. But they also carry the water within their womb, and all of life is born of a woman, we know that. You have spoken of that often, and that is so true. I feel that the words of Yeshua were deliberately misinterpreted. And I say deliberately because he said, or it was written that he said, go into the house of the man who is the water bearer. This manipulation was deliberate to ignore the woman as the bearers of water, the bearers of life. It's because we are transitioning into the time of enlightenment. That's what this is. It's about the return of the sacred feminine. That's a prophecy, which means harmony and balance and peace, walking side by side, sacred feminine, sacred masculine, as we are, and reinstating the ways of the clan mothers. And this signifies our pathway into the new world. This is what the new world is meant to be. The question is, will the earth be separated into two worlds? Will a portal be opened into the new earth as a parallel world, free from the hierarchical control? This new world that we are entering, moving towards, or into is being manifested at present by those who are raising their frequencies. We could call them light workers, or you could call them enlightened ones, those that are coming awake, those that are turning to Creator, to the sacred laws. That's the frequency I'm talking about. Although the transitions have occurred in the past, we've done this before. We've been through this cycle before. I think the difference is, this is the first time, perhaps, that an entire planet will make the shift into another dimension. But this is about each one of us taking our power back and determining the way to transition. How will we get there? Will we continue to come back, reincarnate, we call it, right? A return to the same situation again and again. I think the time is the transition into the higher frequencies, as we speak about a lot. That's how we're going to make this shift. We are being asked to shift in alignment with the mother's transition, to align ourselves with her energy, with her frequency too. In order to enter this new world that we are calling the Age of Enlightenment, 1,000 years of peace. So I just want to finish here with this thought about the battle of the dark and the light. It's a spiritual battle, I feel very strongly, because it's about our spiritual self, our spirituality, our connectedness to Creator, Mother, Father, and the choice, choose, our free will. Are we going to choose ignorance, or are we going to choose spiritual enlightenment, Creator? Also, we talk about those that are manipulating us daily, incrementally, for centuries. This is nothing new. But, you know, this is a time that we have to really awaken here, get smart. Otherwise, we're not going to shift. We're not going to be able to move into that new time, that new world. Whatever it may be, that's up to Creator. I think the best way for us is to hold strong that faith. There is going to be an end, and there is going to be a beginning. So the new world, those that are manipulators are bringing in the Antichrist. Now, I believe that the meaning of that symbol is not specifically a person, but that it is a corrupted everything that is sacred and the evil that is against all of creation. So to me, I feel this is where we are. We have to open our eyes, our hearts, and our ears, and listen to the guidance. Everything is significant that we do now. Everything. The way we walk, the way we speak, the way we behave, or are caring for each other or not, or ignoring the sorrow of our neighbors. How lost are we? How far removed are we from Creator, Mother, Father? This is going to be essential. The distance, far removed from Creator, from the sacred laws or the law of one. Where are we going to be? How are we going to move? How are we going to transition? It's all up to us individually. And I feel strongly that it's about the sacred ways of the people, of our ancestors, and loving everything, all this creation, and being grateful. You know, it's the time now, as we said, of the return of the sacred feminine, and the clan mother's ways. These are the ancestors' ways. I know some still maintain these ways, which is really beautiful, but the elite are working even still now to destroy this way, to destroy the original way, because they fear it. And that's what we have to know. We have to remember that they fear us. They fear the power that we have. I just want to say that there. Thank you. Philomaya.
Oh, thank you so much for that. Wonderful ladies, clan mothers, thank you so much for that. Those opening statements, to be able to stand on that foundation coming from the clan mothers is exactly what we as men are asked to do. So I thank you for those wonderful words. The next individual I'll pass the talking stick, if I may, is to Sydney. So go ahead, Sydney.
Hello, Gerald. Thank you. And all the panel. Okay, I've been thinking about this for a while now. We have to go back to George Washington's time. And after George Washington became president, everything became everything changed. But before that, the treaties that were made before George Washington, everything was legitimate at that time. But when George Washington came, a lot of things changed at that time. And simple words like manifest destiny, doctrine of discovery, severality, guardianship, alienation have been used. And this ICE maritime law and this new law that they go by, every time we agreed to something, there's been treaties amended. We've been making treaties from even from 1876. Even after that, we've been making treaties. And a lot of people don't understand that. They don't know. Vote 10 money, vote 15 money. We changed our course and decided to go corporate route because of that choice. And we've been given choices, and we went the wrong way every time. We went after the money. We went after survival mode, I guess. And now we've been doing that, amending the treaties, even though our people have not known that they were entering into modern-day treaties. And we're getting deeper and deeper into our own buffalo jump, so to speak. We're, what you call that, slowly, our treaty rights are deteriorating. There's no treaty rights. By 2017, there'll be no treaties in Canada. We'll be assimilated like everybody. And the panel's been talking about manipulation and being deceived by these entities. Nobody's doing the studying, and hardly a few people study. There's been a few only people waking up. Every community has a few people that woke up. And even the ones that woke up, sometimes they don't do nothing because they don't know where to go. There's only going to be a handful of people that woke up and smelled the coffee. And I always say, congratulate those people that have woke up and continue to struggle regardless of the. It's very tough to walk in this narrow road that we've been walking on. And I'm sure it's going to get tougher yet. But I feel that the power sometimes, the prayer works, ceremonies work. And so this is where we are today with this laws coming in, legislations, or the corporation have these policies and what you call statutes that are not real law, but corpus juris secundum. So we have, they made it look like it's the real law, common law. So again, I wanted to point out that a lot of the courtrooms continue, even though they know they're operating on maritime law and second law of the land. They've been given the mandate to push, regardless of what's going on. So it's every judge has his own choice to make. Sometimes we have a good judge, sometimes we don't. So this is where we're talking about IGU and NGO, the panel. I'm sure everybody's heard about that, taking our certificates, birth certificates, and trying to get our names out of the corporate world and creating our own live births and our social insurance number as well, that they quit making money on that and then become, we have our own bonds so we can deal with these ourselves and our own, however we want to continue in this day and age. So, Gerald, I'd like to drop off for about 5 minutes. I want to phone Steve, while we were on the phone there. I think he wanted some help in Big Head.
What's that?
Ernest Sundown, I think, wants help over there.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll drop off for a while, then I'll come back on. I'll phone me back in about 5 minutes, 10 minutes.
Will do.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for that, Sydney. And yes, definitely things are happening. Situations are being performed by the dark side. And we have to react to it. And they already have the solution. The solution is one world government through the United Nations. That is exactly what they intend to do. So I'd just like to bring that up for your attention. So to bring things into perspective, to see exactly what they're up to and what they intend to do. So with that, I'd like to pass the talking stick, if I may, to Stephen. So go ahead, Stephen.
Hello. Thank you.
Yeah, go ahead.
My name is Omigwaniyawasis, which means winged cow in English. And I live in Loon Lake, Saskatchewan, corporate fictional province of Saskatchewan in the Treaty 6 area. The whole 121,000 square miles that was ceded over by our great grandfathers. I'd just like to bring to the attention of the people that are listening. And we were talking about Meredith Quinn. I receive a lot of information of his writings about 4, 5, 10 years ago. And you got to listen to every word to what I'm going to say, because when you say Caucus Omacious, it means the white race clan mothers. And then we got the North American Indian woman clan mothers. So there's a big difference between the word Caucus Omacious and the American Indian clan mothers. So if you call yourself a Caucus Omacious, then you're following, then you fall under the white race clan mother rule or law. So you got to watch that. And another thing too is I keep posting on my Facebook about the word Native American. If you call yourself Native American, then you weren't born in America. Noah created Native. So we are North American Indians. That's who we are, or American Indians, for that matter. And we belong to the Americas Empire, and 52 nations strong of the Iroquois Confederacy. We're part of it. And I keep telling people, I keep saying this, I keep asking questions. If the Treaty 6 area, the peace pipe was used during the negotiations, and the foundations to international law, one of them is the Peace Pipe Treaty. And Sydney just pointed out a little while ago here that the year 2017, they're going to do away with these treaties. So last Sunday when we talked about this, Treaty 6 is supposed to be a covenant, because the Creator, Great Spirit, was a witness to the treaty because of the pipe. Peace pipe that was used during the negotiations. But you got to realize, and I like to mention to the people listening, if you want to know more about Meredith Quinn, you just go to YouTube and punch in Meredith Quinn's Universal Law, and there's 9 videos, 10, 15 minutes long videos of his teachings. And when I say, if you call yourself Native American or Caucasomasis, you'll hear him say, remember one wrong word and it'll kill you. And those two words are Caucasomasis and Native American. They can put you in a ship and push you offshore off North America or South America, and you go back to where you belong if you're Native American. And I do a little bit of I'm involved in my cultural, but then again, there's two different types of elders nowadays. You got the corporate elder and the elder like me, who don't go around using my pipe or lifting pipes for corporate governments, like the chief and councils, tribal councils. Those are the corporate elders that they use. Sometimes we call them popcorn elders. When the money is involved, there's all kinds of elders that are popping up all over. In our local MLTC, Meadow Lake Tribal Council, we have an elders liaison officer there. And when I travel on the Sundance Trail or these other ceremonial trails, I don't see this guy there singing or praying with the pipe to help other people. And this is what I'm saying, you got the popcorn elders and traditional elders. So you gotta watch for that, because the federal government at one time banned all ceremonies, like the sun dance, ghost dance, and chicken dance, and the horse dance, and you name it. There's 6 different ceremonies, 7 different ceremonies that we still do up here in our area, which is called Loon Lake, Saskatchewan. In Cree, it's Maqua Sagayran. And where I live, just north of me, is where Big Bear and Major Steele fought in the 1886. That was the last place where the last fire was ever shot in the Canadian soil. You don't hear that in the news, or they just want to cover it up because of what the treaties. Stamosquaw, Big Bear, didn't want to sign treaty with the Queen or whoever it was that came and sent Alexander Morris over here until around 1885 or 86. That's when he signed the treaty, because his people were starving. So he had to do something to keep alive. But they charged him for treason when his people started killing those people in Frog Lake, Alberta. And where I live, just north of me, about a mile north of me, is where it was the last fire ever shot in the Canadian soil. And like I said, they won't hear that in the news because the federal government was ashamed of what they did. They try to keep everything under the table. I drive there every day, and they got plaques or whatever describing what happened on June, I forgot the day, but 1886, I think it was. But the people listening, just remember, if you call yourself Caucus Comasis, then you're under the white race Clan Mother's law. Then we have the North American Indian Woman Clan Mothers. Those are the ones that are title holders of the land they occupy. We don't own the land. We're the first Instamino. I always call myself Instamino, means original occupant of the Turtle Island, Miskinakministik. That's how you say Miskinak is a turtle, Ministik is an island. That's how we say it in Cree, Miskinakministik. And we're the original occupants of Turtle Island, Taminook of Miskinakaminstabook. And with that, I'd like to say hello to all of you people. I've been away for a while because I have my ups and downs too, because sometimes when you do a ceremony for other people, you know, when something like I say, there's a lot of popcorn elders around now, and they don't follow the protocol. One guy told me he travels the powwow trail. they were having a ceremony on Onion Lake, and this guy must have came over there and started taping me while I was singing in that ceremony. And next thing he said, I heard your songs down in Connecticut. What's the name of that town there? But that's where he went and heard my songs being played on tape. So this is with all the modern technology nowadays, you know, you can do this. You can steal songs without doing the proper protocol. This is what's happening right now. I kind of shy away from all these. Right now they're having a Sundance right now today on my reserve. But like I say, you got the popcorn elders all. So I kind of shy away from it now because they don't do the proper protocol to come and give me a print and cigarettes or tobacco to go help them out. So you gotta watch this, because now, from now, today, that's what's going to be happening. And with that, I'd like to thank every one of you that's listening, and I'll hand back the talking stick to Gerald. Hi.
Hi. Thank you so much for that, Stephen. I got to commend you for all the hard work that you've done carrying out your ceremonies. And I'd like to say that to all the people who are present, because exactly what Sydney has been talking about, there's a word that he mentioned, corpus juris secundum, the second law of the land. Corpus means corporation or corpse. Juris means oath spoken. And secundum means the second. The corpus juris secundum is a law that they have made, which deals specifically on contracts.
Gerald.
Yes, go ahead.
Please
do. Go ahead.
All right. The word caucus from Mesa's, those are the white race clan mothers. And every full moon, they get together and sing the song of the Pantoras Tara plagues. And they send it to the Indian people. And every full moon, me and the wife and a few of our friends, we get together, we have our sweat, and we try to send the evil stuff back away from us. So this is what they do, is the white race clan mothers. If you guys go to that YouTube and punch in on Meredith Quincy Universal Law, you'll hear him say that they go someplace every full moon. You know, he tried to follow them, but he couldn't. So we got to be aware that every full moon, the white race clan mothers, caucus from Asus, get together and sing the song of the Pantoras Tara plagues. And every high noon, there's another group. I think these are men now. They pray at high noon, and something about the saints on the divine. That's why they're trying to keep the
Time Walker
Society from spiritually awakening on our reserves, or right across North America, for that matter. Okay, Osama, hi.
Thank you so much for that information. I'd like to also mention, just extend it, and regarding the song of the men that sing every high noon. Well, as a matter of fact, it is after 2 o'clock, so somewhere on Earth it's high noon.
Must be in BC, in our part.
Exactly. So this group of men, and I believe it's the Masonic Lodge, along with the rabbis who practice Judaism, are singing this song every 57 minutes. So just imagine the journey of the sun across the sky. And every time there's certain land, when it's high noon, they sing the song of St. John Divine. And the song that they sing is the energy that they're carrying out to the government policy. So people like Prime Minister Harper, who is just a puppet, and also that he is carrying out the orders of the international bankers, which is being controlled by the synagogue of Satan. They say they are Jews, but are not, but they lie. These groups of people are singing the song every 57 minutes, wherever there is these white men pretending to be Jews. They call them Kazarians, Zionists, Masons. So with that in mind, so that the energy that they are sending, do not forget what Tracy's talking about at the beginning of the program, this energy. So this energy that we're talking about is that we, in the process of activating the Time Walkers, so that they know what time of the day it is in the here and now. In the here and now, across, we have sunshine on this side, 2 o'clock. On the other side of the world, it's darkness. But I want to bring to your attention, now this is going to blow your minds, and it might not register. But I want you to think about what was being said, like people like David Icke. The Creator and His creation is all there is, and everything else is an illusion. Right above us, on an angle, is a North Star, which is heaven. Earth and heaven are together in what we're talking about here, and the communication must always come from heaven to earth and earth to heaven. in carrying out our ceremonies. The question is, do we revolve around the orbit of the sun? The answer is no. Earth is motionless. There's experiments that they have done, interferometer experiments, that the science proved that the Earth is motionless. So the sun revolves around our Earth, as all the rest of the other planets and the stars revolve around Earth because of creation. Put that in your pipe and smoke it. And this communication that we are talking to the Creator is a gentleman that has started this revolution. It's called Copernicus, who said that we revolve around the sun in an orbit. I was also talking about this in many radio programs in regards to this. But to be able to prove that the creation is always above as below. With that introduction, I'd like to pass the talking stick on to Lance. And please expound on that for us, my friend. Go ahead. Are you there, Lance? Okay, well, that's fine. So with that in mind, I'd like to also mention that at the beginning of the program, when we tried to phone Ernest Sundown, and we heard that Sydney phoned him, is I'd like to mention to all the panel heard it, and all you ladies and gentlemen, dear listeners, brothers and sisters, Ernest Sundown's ex-wife's mother passed away. So our condolences definitely go out to their family, Ernest and his ex-wife, Judy. But that's precisely exactly what we mean. It's pretty unfortunate that a lot of our people have to come home in a pine box. I guess in a way we could look at it as saying it's a sacrifice to the evil cabal. And in order for us to be able to understand that does, even talked about many things, and in particular causes of Mises. And he says the head clan mother of the white race. This white race have been genetically manipulated by the fallen angels to create a race here on Earth. And this white race are these 13 satanic bloodlines. And they occupy top positions of power in the government, religion, the economy, education, for their destiny, for a one world government. So when we're talking about causes of Mises, does not ever remind you, for those people that know the Bible, we call her the Mystery Babylon, a temple being placed into the Tower of Babel, where all the things in commerce, where the people on the satanic bloodline became the masters and we became the slaves. They became the creditors, we become the debtors. And so on and so forth. In their commercial game, because the international bankers, the money is a medium of exchange. The money is debt paper, it's an IOU. That piece of paper that you get, a check from the different sources that you might be employed in. Some of us get it from the government. But that piece of paper has to be endorsed by our signature. And you take it to the bank or the store, wherever you're going to cash it. We transfer that into their money, the dollar. Yes. So now that we have the dollar, they do not tax you, ladies and gentlemen. They do not tax you. They tax the money, which is declassified to be income tax. that they have labeled in the creation of the Federal Reserve in 1913. In 1933, the gold standard was taken out. In 1935, it was entered the Great Seal of the United States, the two great seals on the American dollar. You can see it. So every country, the United States became bankrupt in 1933, and the Federal Reserve took over all commercial activity in the United States as well as all over the world. The currency that the world is going by is the American dollar. United States is forcing everybody to buy into their American dollar, and as a result, Canada has to buy American dollars. And Canada is registered in the United States Security Exchange Commission, United States Corporation Security. What is your security? Your security, ladies and gentlemen, is your birth certificate, which is worth a lot of money. And that birth certificate that was created by Vital Statistics after your mother signed the certificate of live birth, and in this case, us, a live birth of an Indian, where the Dominion of Canada and the Parliament made laws in regards to this, to transfer us and to register us. And the word registration of anything is a voluntary act of surrender, of custody of the property, and the establishment of an account that can be charged in the name given. So upper lower case that was written on my birth certificate of live birth of an Indian, upper and lower case was written. They sent it to the Vital Statistics, as well as you American people. They're sent to the county Vital Statistics. They give you a birth certificate, and they changed your name to an all-caps name, which is your straw man. That is the law that they are using, your all-caps name, all the statutes, all the law, the codes, come from
Gerald.
This.
Yo. What about that word, informant?
Informant, that means that our mothers have given us up. Informants. Pardon me?
Father, my name is the informant.
Say that again.
Informant, the father is the informant.
Yes, both of them play a part. But I want you to pay particular attention exactly what Stephen is asking. And Sydney talked about maritime law or admiralty law. Are all of you guys lost in sea? Barbara talked about that water. Aren't you women classified to be a ship, and you're womb to be a cargo, and you come to a birth? A ship coming to birth? Is the cargo inside our mother's womb to be delivered in a delivery room? That the doctor, a franchisee to the federal government, working for the federal government, there has to be a manifest that has to be presented. And that manifest is a certificate of live birth to us as Indians, a certificate of a live birth of an Indian, based on the laws of Dominion and Parliament of Canada, which was created by virtue of the DNA Act, the Constitution that was written in England. My goodness. When John MacDonald brought that Constitution, he rewrote it and he took out the preamble. He rewrote the DNA Act and brought it to Canada and said, we got a constitution, which is fraudulent at get-go. So with that, and everybody in Canada, July the 1st, oh, they praised the fathers of our Confederation here in Canada. They praised them. So in regards to this, Causus Omasis, the white clan mother of the white race, genetically manipulated, Mystery Babylon. And Mystery Babylon, the mother of Nimrod, Semiramis. Nimrod married his mother. And Semiramis is a Statue of Liberty sitting in a harbor of New York. A lot of people coming to the United States thinking that they're going to get freedom, liberty. Yes, of course, they're going to get freedom. Freedom from what? Freedom by not following the Creator. That's what that statue represents, ladies and gentlemen, dear panel. You heard Sydney talk about George Washington, the first Masonic president legally. In the word apotheosis of George Washington, making man into a god. In the rotunda in the Capitol building, you look at the ceiling. You see a picture where God is supposed to sit. George Washington is sitting there with all the rest of the spiritual beings that the Creator is supposed to have created. Where did George Washington get to become a god? Through Roman law. The Roman law of the nations. Indeed. But in regards to the Roman law, in the Roman Senate, did they not, in fact, make Julius Caesar into a god? And Julius Caesar was considered to be a god, and Julius Caesar married the white-clad mother of the white tribes, Cleopatra, which came from Egypt. And the son that they had is Caesarian. It's not ever a wonder why a woman, when they cannot have a normal birth, their wombs and their stomach are cut wide open. Why? Makes you kind of wonder, doesn't it? With our understanding, we know why they have done that. To force the birth of a child to be born on that birth, on that date. Like Prince William. Princess Diana had to be a virgin. She was artificially inseminated with a seed, a serpent seed, which developed. The son became Prince William. They had cloned the blood that they got from the Shroud of Turin. Does Prince William have the body of Yeshua through the Shroud of Turin? Makes you kind of think, doesn't it? With everything that they're doing in regards to genetic manipulation, artificial intelligence, by first of all creating chemtrails, and there's a lot of things within those chemtrails, the clouds that came from jet planes. Those things are coming down, they're affecting us one way or the other. Notice the symptoms. When you see those chemtrails, and you will know what I'm talking about. So they have these things all planned. Why are they doing this? Because, ladies and gentlemen, their race is dying. So in that computer that Tracy's talking about, artificial intelligence, This computer can think for itself. It can speak for itself. And this computer has been programmed for all the information in regards to creation has been fed into that computer. Your names are written in that computer, and your racial profile, your DNA, is in there. The bloodline is such a concern to them, like Kenneth Crew's situation. The United States government used blood quantum, and Kenneth Crew and his family, as all some members of the Wahpeton Reserve, qualify for that, and in particular, Kenneth Crew has 75% of the bloodline, which qualifies him to be sovereign. Canadian government recognizes Kenneth Crew to be sovereign. The United States government recognizes him to be sovereign. Kenneth Crew has dual citizenship. He has land in Minnesota. So what is the next step for him to do? Commercially, he needs a negotiable debt instrument. At this point in time, I have not sent my documents to any of you at this time, but my documents are complete. In the future, to be able to present these documents so that each one of you could also have your own documents, but you're in your own name. Here I have an indemnity bond, and I'd like to read to you quickly what this says. Indemnity bond, each one of you, dear panel, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, dear listeners, you need to make yourself an indemnity bond to protect yourself against these goons that are receiving their conditioning from the evil cabal. Let me read, and I quote, "Know all men by these present that Gerald Chester Eisbister, copyright, the debtor hereby establishes this indemnity bond in favor of Wapastimganipowit, the secured party, in the sum of future collateral values up to the sum of $90 billion United States dollars. For the payment on which bond, the debtor hereby firmly binds its successors, heirs, and executors, administrators, doing business as known as DBA and AKAs, and third party assigns jointly and severally. The debtor hereby indemnifies the secured party against losses incurred as a result of all claims of debts and or losses made by any and all persons against the commercial transactions and investments of the debtor. The condition of this bond is that the secured party covenants to do certain things on behalf of the debtor as set forth in the attached security. Agreement of the same date and executing parties and debtor covenants to serve as a transmitting unity to assure beneficial interest of all accounts established and managed by the United States / Canada, and all goods and services in commerce are available to or conveyed from debtor to secured party, whichever is appropriate, to avert losses vested rights in the present or future collateral that is subject to the attached security agreement. The debtor agrees to make available the secured party accounts established by intent of the parties by operation of law and or as constructive trusts to hold proceeds arising from assets belonging to the debtor and administered by the United States / Canada or its subdivisions, agents, or affiliates. Pursuant to existing laws of the United States / Canada and the agreement of the parties of the attached security agreement, the secured party is authorized to assign such funds from said accounts as are necessary to settle all past, present, and future public debts and obligations incurred by the debtor on behalf of the secured party. The debtor, without benefit of discussion or division, does hereby agree, covenant, and undertake to indemnify, defend, and hold the secured party harmless from against and any of all claims, losses, liabilities, costs, interest, and expenses, including without restriction legal costs, interest, penalties, and fines previously suffered or incurred, or to be suffered or incurred by the secured party in accordance with the secured party's personal guarantee with respect to loans or indebtedness belonging to the debtor, including any amount the debtor might be deemed to owe to a public creditor for any reason whatsoever. The secured party shall promptly advise the debtor of all public claims brought by third parties against the present or future property of the debtor, all of which is covered by the attached security agreement up to indemnification amount declared herein, and to provide the debtor with the full details of said claims, including copies of all documents, correspondence, suits, or actions received by or served upon a debtor through the secured party. Secured party shall fully cooperate with the discussion, negotiation, or other proceedings related to such claims. This bond shall be in force and effect as of the date it is assigned and accepted by the parties, and provided that the secured party may cancel this bond and be relieved of further duty hereunder by delivering a 30-day written notice of cancellation to the debtor. No such cancellation will affect the liability incurred by accrued the secured party prior to the conclusion of said 30 days period. If such event of notice of cancellation, and in the event that the United States / Canada reinstitutes its constructive claim against the collateral, the debtor agrees to reissue the bond before the end of 30-day period for the amount equal to or greater than the above value of the attached security agreement. Unless the parties agree otherwise, equity under the law is paramount. You are using my exemption. On this day, on this 17th day of October 2008, Gerald Chester Eisbiter, indemnitor, Gerald Chester Eisbiter, copyright. Creditor accepts the debtor's signature in accordance with the Uniform Commercial Codes 1-20, brackets 39, and section 3401B, by the authority of Kawimowski tribal family. Indemnity, Wapostim Kanifot, authorized representative. Unquote. There is my indemnity for $90 billion United States dollars. I'll adopt each one of you, and I will pay your bills. Do you hear me? Any responses from anybody? Tracy?
Absolutely. And by then, I should have your power source ready. Oh, sorry about that. Yeah, that sounds wonderful, Gerald. Very looking forward to it. Patty asked a question. Would you mind?
Sure, by all means. Go ahead, Patty.
I could say it, or you can say it, Patty. Up to you. Okay, she asked about the prayers being done. And, you know, I've talked about there are three times during the day that are the most powerful. One is before the sun rises. And if you do happen to get up at that time, you know that all of our family, and I mean all around the world, used to do this. It is very silent. Almost everything stops. The birds, it's like everything holds its breath. And then the sun comes up. There's a powerful healing energy. It can be healing, or it can be used for very nefarious things. So that's when the sun rises, and it's new and it's young. So it's the rebirth. This is why you can get that energy and be reborn. At noon, which is never exactly at noon, but you'd be surprised to find online, you can find out exactly when the midpoint of the day is, because people are watching this. Yes, it used to be women standing there, but Gerald gave us a clue because of what they said they're doing. The power to change men into gods. A man cannot be a god. You want creation. You do not send one guy. So what's chanting right now at the midpoint of the day? Possibly all over the world, but definitely on either of our coasts. I'm 100% with you on that. The midpoint of the day, and we were asked in the room, what language? The language, too, is fairly obvious to me, because the majority of this world, no matter what they spoke, has been told to speak English. English is very dark. It is a programming language. It beats everything that came before it, because it's a combination of certain energies. This world, these words do not come back void. They reprogram our DNA. It's why we have to be really careful right now what we say. And so these men are the cross-dressing pedophiles that Gerald and I have spoken to of. And these are the jinn, or the Jesuits. It's why the Bible starts with Jen. It's why they sell blue jeans. It's why they're looking for a blue fish to make their blue cloth. It's telling you the manipulation here. It's why I was a little concerned about Kesh being in a place of the jinn, being in a place that says they have the first book, because the first book was the jinn book. And we did not defile trees to make our books. This is relatively new. So know that it's all been manipulated for this. Yes, Jen Isis. Hello, this is the money. This is why they're using Mary against us, maritime law. So it's all weapons and warships now, when it should have been the waters. When women, I am the mothership. Our waters are the mother. Them putting ships on it and sailing it and using it against us for currency. Currency is the flow of water. This is insidious what even our words mean when you sit. And you guys are rocking that today. And high five to all the panel, because it's powerful, right? Powerful. This is what they're doing. They use that time of day at noon. And again, you can look it up and find out what it is. That time of day, you need to stop whatever the heck you're doing, even for a minute, and you go out there. We fight by being aware of what they've done to us. And it's why there's July and June, like Gerald said, and this is a Caesar, this is a Caesarian. It is a sea, it is the womb opened, ripped, defiled, unveiled, if you will. And why they keep presenting us with J's, Jesuits, that is the hook in said ocean. This is in catching, these are the fishers of men. And whatever you believe, whoever you call to, if you feel the need to call to someone, just you can tell without looking at any other language what this language means, what it's supposed to do. And English has become the reprogramming language. So we need to be as sweet and gentle and loving as possible. We can fight this. We absolutely can fight this. This is why, David, you take the AI and put it on one side. You got DVD on the other, and that's that circular disc that is used for programming. This is not a boy. This is not a child. This is something dangerous. And right now, CERN, Jade Helm, and Windows 10 specifically, our avatar specifically, are trying to make you part of the node. They've done everything they can, right from the Prussian education system and then the introduction of PhDs, because we didn't have those here. And the defilement of our people worldwide, all of our people, all different shades, who used to sing the same song, used to know how to worship the mother, used to know how to speak to the trees. And it's why even what they are saying they're doing. The oldest thing, there would not be life on the surface of the planet if there were not trees. The first tree all over the world is a pine. That's why they're holding the pine cone. They are saying that they are gods now. They are not gods. They are cross-dressing pedophiles. That's why they keep being caught at this. These are men in dresses, and there's nothing wrong with men in dresses, of course. But men in dresses usually love women. These men do not. They love your little boys and little girls. And we are at an insidious time, and I'm hoping what Gerald just said and what I'm working on right now will free us. And knowing these things, don't be afraid to say them. You know, don't be afraid to know them. Somebody asked me, sent me a message today, and I had to laugh because I think I'd be the last person on the earth who's going to ask me this. But they said that they had dark entities following them. I said, well, you can embrace your dark side, or you could stop being dark. They're following you for a reason. Choose not to. Do what Two Dog did. Choose not to. See it. Know it's you that you're looking at. Know it wouldn't come to you if you didn't have a part of that. But that's part of the game. This is part of the play and the funness of this reality we're living in. We have all of these terrible things, but we could choose something else. And we still have that power. So thank you very much, guys. You've blown my mind today.
Oh, that is truly remarkable and also wonderful to be able to say that. But you notice something, the journey within. The answer lies within each one of you. Barbara mentioned it before, light, sound, vibration, and frequency. But we know that light travels faster than sound. So the light will come to you, but the sound will wait. It's slower. So be patient. Everything that we're talking about today is in our midst. We become spiritual beings of light, walking in this darkness of evil. The people who are controlling it are afraid of us because we are light. Yes, like what they tried to do to Two Dog. But remember, the greatest energy that you have is love. Love to be distributed within every aspect of your life where the Creator is. That energy will definitely come to you. Did you hear what I said, Stephen?
Yeah.
As to your ceremonies, to what we're talking about. And you're carrying out your duty faithfully. No matter what happens, you know the protocol. You have remained steadfast in what you have done. You have stood on that truth. And all the rest of the people like Barbara and her ceremonies, I commend all of you, along with Tracy and all the rest of the panel members. Indeed. This is where we're at now. We got about 14 minutes, 15 minutes. What I like to do is start with the women with the last 15 minutes to bring your thoughts and feelings. Remember what I said, thought from your head, the intelligence that you have, and the feelings that come from your heart. When both come of it out of your mouth, that becomes the sword of the spirit, which is the words in our language that we carry in our mantras. So go ahead, ladies. Barbara? Okay, so go ahead, Patty.
Well, thank you, Gerald. I do want to say also that it's been a wonderful panel today. Tracy, you continually open my eyes, show me new things that I didn't even conceive before. I'm learning so much because of you, and I thank you for that. Gerald, you do the same. And Stephen, I know your truth. I do want to say, if I can shortly, there is one thing that we talk about always. It is the first law, the Creator's law. We talk about the harmony within that law. Yet we find ourselves petitioning the law of man in order to live under the first law. I don't understand the conception of this, but it may not be for me to understand this. I do know that you are who you are in every moment of your life. You are who you choose to be. No one can make you what you don't choose to be. You have the power of creation within you at all times, and communication with creation at all times. There is no time that you are alone. The truths that you need are within you. No man upon this earth has the right to tell you who you are. Only you can define that. Only you can stand in that truth. And it's a choice. Thank you, Gerald.
Oh, thank you. Some wonderful words that you have conveyed to us. Indeed, Patty, thank you so much. Barbara? Oh, Barbara's gone. Tracy, any final words?
Just saying this is a very powerful time we're in. It's dangerous, yes, but we can be more than this. We can. And we are. We always have been. We've always fought this power. Thank you.
Indeed. Indeed. Well said, Tracy, indeed. So I commend both of you ladies, keep up the good work, to spread this message of exactly what we're talking about on this radio program is greatly needed. Indeed. So I'd like to pass the talking stick, if I may, to Stephen.
Hello.
Go ahead, sir.
I'd like to thank the Creator, Great Spirit, for giving us another time to speak to one another. And I hope what I said didn't offend anybody, but the truth has to be passed out amongst the people. And with that, I'd like to say hi, hi, and thank you. Hi, hi.
Oh, definitely. Thank you so much for that, Stephen. So no matter what we say or do, my friend, panel members, dear ladies, we are going to offend a lot of people. The people, the difference is the people that are walking in darkness, we have offended them. The people who are struggling at this time walking in light definitely do have a duty and responsibility to carry out to the best of our ability, no matter what happens. That is the legacy that our people have left for us in regards to the ancient stories of our people, in regards to prophecy, entering into the fifth world, We are ready to take those necessary steps in order for us to get there, no matter what happens, because I know that the Creator is in charge. And the Creator is choosing certain individuals on Mother Earth, and you might be one of them. But many are called, but few are chosen. And those people that are chosen at this point in time will surely and honestly bring us forward by taking necessary step in what Tracy and all the rest of the panel members have talked about, which is remarkable indeed. So, did Sydney get back on? Patty? Okay, there's just Barbara's gone, just you. Holy Walker dropped off. With all the rest of the dear listeners that are listening to this radio program, do not be afraid anymore. The light has come. The energy from the sun is increasing the photons, and it's coming in the form of gold dust. And that gold dust will embed on your skin and will definitely enter in. And with that being said, we are on the verge of something, a paradigm shift, if you may. In regards to the weather patterns, we all know and experience this, and I heard that there was snow in Australia and New Zealand. Unheard of. Many things are happening, but please remember that our Mother Earth, Simantusquo, the Creator Mother, is motionless right now, and above her is the Creator Father. And with that in mind, we know that the energy that comes from the Divine Mother, Mother Earth, is definitely given to the women at this point in time. It is remarkable to be able to be a part of this, to become the solution in regards to going back home. Going back home to the Creator, to the Law of One. To be able to structure my life in such a way that all the wonderful things like love, peace, joy, patience, gentleness, goodness, faith, humility, and self-control. This tree that's talking to you now, the fruit that I will produce, is what we shall endeavor to give to all people who are struggling at this point in time. Like I said before at the beginning of the program, please say your prayers for my sister-in-law, Gloria, so that her healing will begin. She has leukemia. So if you all concentrate with this energy that you've been talking about, Tracy, it will surely be done. Yes, we do talk about faith. Biblically, what it says, faith is by hearing and hearing the Word of God. Indeed, what we're talking about is this word. The word that comes from your mind in thinking, both right and left hemisphere, the left side, has to do with linear and logic. That this world, this evil cabal, is perpetuating in the educational system that we were indoctrinated into. We have left out the spiritual aspect of the right side of the brain. So let us build a bridge from what they're teaching us and build that bridge across the super colossum, the divisions in our brain, so that we can go to the spiritual side. To learn to use both sides of the brain at the same time, and you will be in balance. You will be in harmony, no matter what happens, because you have the answer within. The energy of light and love is already inside of you. All you have to do is acknowledge it and open the door for it to be. Everything that the Creator has blessed us with has already been there. Go and get it and make it a part of you. So indeed, this radio program is that we always talk about on spiritual level, but I just mentioned something about the indemnity bond. And hopefully I will send this document to all people on earth so that they could write their own indemnity. To be able to make a dollar figure. And remember, the money that the bankers print out is, they print it out of thin air. What's backed up by the money that they print out is the collateral, and we are that collateral. The security that they have is the birth certificate. Where is your birth certificate? If you have it with you, you are the holder in due course. You are the captain of the ship. Let us say from now on, when they are talking to us, I do not consent to the offer of contract that you have given to me. And this is my offer to you. In my sovereign capacity, I will give you the terms and conditions by which I'm going to base my life. So from this point on, we shall endeavor to do that in what Tracy's working on. And thank goodness that Patty's there also talking on other programs to bring this information home, as well as Barbara and all the rest of the panel members. You shall go forward, always forward. And whenever we take a step backwards, we always have a different way of thinking, knowing that we created a mistake. And we know that we did something wrong, so we have a loving Creator who always embraces us, who is kind and gentle, who is the source of everything in the law of one that has blessed us with in creation. All my relations, everything we are related, the earth, wind, water, and fire, the animals, the birds, the sea creatures, the plants and trees, the insects, the reptiles, are all been created for us because of Yahweh, the Father and Mother, and their Son, which is the Word we are talking about now. So with that, ladies and gentlemen, my brothers and sisters, dear panel members, may the Creator bless you, your people, your family, and your land, wherever you may be. Hi, hi.
Their evils will perish. Let it be so. You're tuned in to Awake Radio. AwakeRadio.us, AwakeRadio.co.uk, Awake Radio Australia, Awake Radio South Africa.